Cromar here, and I'm going to continue with my little training on Facebook groups. Yesterday I shared a way that you could use an image that is kind of unique, but what I like to do is I like to create my own. I have done trainings in the past, but I use Canva, and I can go there real quick and show you the images and what I do with them. But mainly, if you use Canva without having any of the, you don't have to pay for their images. You can create your own. And when you do that, that makes it easier. They even store in here. They don't charge you for storage. And then you can alter them whenever you want. So this is my images I use all the time. Like you can see this one. This is one I've been using a lot in the groups right here. So I'm not going to create a new one, but I just want you to know that this is out there. I uploaded all of the parts to this, and then it's always in here whenever I want it. When all I have to do is click on one of these, and then it's going to show over here the actual stuff that I have saved over the time. I've got quite a bit in there. So you can do anything you want that way and grab particular images that you think are helpful to you. And I have what's called a ping. This is a ping, my face right here, because the background's knocked out. And I just have that where I can put it on any of my images. As you see, I'm using that all over the place on all sorts of different images. So I'm going to come back here to the groups. This is groups. You could just click on groups on the front page, and it'll show you the ones that you've already joined. Now make sure when you do this that you're not doing it inside of any of our special mastermind groups, because that can get you kicked out of the group, and you don't want to do that. So if you're in any groups that they don't allow you to post your own ads, make sure that you are real careful not to do that. But in the case of doing it with this, then remember what I did. I sell something, which is right here, and when you click that, or sometimes you'll find it over here in the more, and it's going to come up looking like this. Well, I've already got a plan on how I'm doing this. So I use my activity tab to find one I've already done so that I don't have to keep repeating. And I copy the same thing over and over again. You can do this and they won't get on your case because it's inside of here. It's not going to be a problem because I like the particular ad. And I'm going to click in here so that I don't get these all crunched together. I want it to show me the way I did it, which I put spaces in between on purpose so that I would not have a problem with how it laid out. I want it to have spaces. I don't want it to be crowded together. And as for space at a price, you really can't put a price on this, obviously. And so what I wrote, now don't use my exact words, because if you do, then Facebook starts saying there's too much repetition, and it ruins it for everybody. Now you can have a link on here, but I've found that doing links usually gets it so that it could get spammed out and it doesn't work. And then the last piece you want to do before you start is to go find your picture. And mine are down in my downloads because it just makes it easier to find it. I know exactly where it is, so I'm going to find my picture. I want to use that one that I've been using in Canva today instead of the one I showed you yesterday. And these are other ones that I've done. I have thumbnails for video and various different things. And as I did yesterday, the other part of that is you don't necessarily have to do it one at a time. Each time that you come in here, it's going to give you a choice of some other places that you may not have already done this. Now, I've done some of these, I think, so I want to make sure that I'm not doing the same ones over and over again. So I'm going to come down here, And I want to make sure also to pay, I like to pay attention to which one I did last. So I write it down. So that I know where I left off. And I try not to do it too fast. That's why I only did five instead of all of the groups at once. Because if you do it really super fast, Facebook can block you out of your Facebook page, groups completely. And that includes the mastermind groups, which means that you won't be able to post or comment. So you don't want that. You want to make sure that you get the opportunity to keep this going. So keep it very slow. Facebook does not get excited if you do it slow. It gets excited if you do it fast. So I'm going to go ahead and post those. And like I said, when you post a small amount, it doesn't give you a bad time. Another thing you can do is you can come back out here to Facebook, and it's going to show your most recent posts. And it'll also give you the opportunity to like your posts so that that gets them a little bit more attention than if you didn't. And sometimes it'll tell you, see, it's posting, it only showed the two groups, so it may not be posting in absolutely every group you're in. But the good thing about this is that you will get more opportunities to send this out than if you had not done it this way. And so that's my kind of follow-up training on how to do it with groups. And you notice when I do these, I do not put a link in here. They have to ask me for it. There's a good reason for that. You make it more interesting and you make it more a little more difficult, and they have to do an extra step. They don't have the laziness of just clicking on the link and immediately afterwards leaving it and not doing anything with it. And because I have Power Lead System, I always give them a capture page, so that lets me know who actually goes there. And then that puts them in, because immediately after the capture page is the page to my one online business, which is a Bitcoin business. And so that gives them the opportunity to see it right away, and it's a really cool page. It even has my own testimony in there, so it's kind of cool. I like that page a lot, so I make sure that they can get to that quickly. But I want them to be on my capture page, because that also allows me to send them emails. I have both automated emails set up, and I send out emails twice a day. The first one is usually about training, and the second one is automatically set up as I create a blog post. Then it lets me send out to them that I have a blog post ready for them to go see. So that's what I have going on with that. So I hope that helps you, and I hope you enjoy this training. Let me know what you think.